Next week's opening up is a major step.
Sharp stretch coming.
And it's vaccines that have given the government the injection of confidence it needs to take it.
The vaccines are producing very effective reduction in hospitalizations and death. We know that they're also reducing onward transmission. All of that points to this now being a much smoother path.
Behind the veneer of the Number 10 briefing room lies hefty scientific analyses by three different academic groups predicting the impact of easing restrictions. Professor Azra Ghani led one of them.
The main thing is really that we have been cautious in the unlocking, so the infection rates have come down before we started to release the measures, and that means we'll be starting at a much lower level with a much higher proportion of the population vaccinated, and that will set us up in a much better place for the future.
Her team's analysis predicts more infections, but far fewer than before. The number of people ending up in hospital with COVID may be around 55,000 over the next 12 months. And while deaths in England may number around 9,000 in that period, for context, compare that to flu deaths. In the winter of 2015-16, there were around 7,500 in England. A bad winter, like 2017-18, saw more than 22,000 deaths from flu. But there's still a lot of uncertainty about those projections.
It's very difficult to map out specific patterns of mixing, for example, going to the pub or going to a nightclub, and what that will mean in terms of transmission. All we can think about is, in generic terms, we know indoor mixing and crowded spaces are higher risk for transmission.
Given how hard it is to predict how all of us and the virus will behave when we reopen things like pubs and restaurants fully, the estimates for how many hospitalizations and deaths there might be remain pretty vague. And the analyses don't even take into account the impact of new variants or a major disruption to the vaccination programme, both of which could still derail the roadmap. Barring any unpleasant surprises, how the virus spreads in the coming weeks will start to give us an idea of how dominant COVID will be in our lives from now on. Tom Clark, News at 10.